your background and also what you've done in the community. Now, I understand that your father was a pastor. In what ways or how has your father influenced you?
My father was a pastor within the SIB church. His life has indeed influenced me very much. He comes from the first batch of pastors being trained by the missionaries in the early 1950s after the war. He was a very disciplined man, and I still remember even now our the brothers and sisters are still talking about the fact that one of the things that we really appreciate was the fact that both my father and my mother were very disciplined in the area of prayer. Secondly, he has a lot of good advice, and one of the many advices that he imparted to us kids, and which I still hold on to until today, is this. I said, son, people would fear you when you do what is right. I think that's the thing that really encouraged me even through my profession as lawyer and as a leader in the church to do what is right. I think that has helped me focus on what I'm doing at the moment. I think that has given me a great encouragement to the years, and I think you'll never go wrong. I mean, if you really focus on doing what you think is right in accordance with what you believed in particular as a Christian, based on this Christian principle that I come to know. When I went to further my study, and by God's grace, and also in a very special way, I believe God has opened the door for me to go to Australia, and I made it to cut back. And there God somehow challenged me to come back and use my talent as a lawyer to come back and do what I can as a lawyer. And I remember the verse in Proverbs, I think it was Proverbs 31, therein, where my wife, then my girlfriend, then was challenging me to be the spokesperson for the needy, the defenseless, and those that they can speak for themselves. And when I came back in the mid 1980s, then it was a time when the Penans, the native Penans, the nomadic Penans were fighting for their environment, and that was the scenario that I came back in those days. So I was challenged with that words, you know. Not many of us are lawyers. By the time I got back, I think I was then the fifth person that graduated as a lawyer from my community. And I was in Kuala Lumpur for a while. I started chambering. I got admitted in the High Court in Kuala Lumpur, and I worked there for 3 years. Then I decided I must come back. On two main reasons then. I thought I should come back as soon as possible because of the land issues, the native customary land issues that Biden, as I've said, was in the forefront. Not only for the Penans, but for all natives of Sarawak then. Then my own native customary land was encroached upon, and it affected my own family, my uncles and my aunties. So I said I must come back and be involved in this and try by all means to defend that rights. That's one of the main reasons. Second reason, of course, is as I look at this whole issue, I look at the bigger picture of the whole thing. It boils down to government policies. It boils down to the present government's way of handling things. And then I thought it would be perhaps time for me to be involved in politics. Basically, that's the reason why I came back, and that's how I began to be involved in this whole aspect of issues in Sarawak.